The moss will keep water for a long time after rain. And this is safe to drink. And it tastes good too. Really good. Tastes real good. And there's a lot of it. You can also find water by digging in the ground. From there, you just use a clean bandana or any piece of clothes. Real good. The bandana is cleaning the water at the same time. Real good. Lots of water. And it will always continue because it's all the water in the ground.
Sometimes, at the junction of trees like this, you can find little pools of water. This one was covered in leaves, but as you remove them, you reach this pool. That said, you may have to search a little bit for these, especially if there was no rain in the last 48 hours. And this water might have been there for a long time, so I would definitely boil it before I drink it. There is another good example, but I don't know if there is water, but I think. Yeah. So if I had no choice, you know, instead of dying, I would drink it and I would be very happy about it.
So as you can see, it's raining right now, so it's a great time to collect water. I will simply use my bandana and rub it against the long grass, and that will suck the water out of it. Oh, it tastes the grass too, it's great. I also thought it was possible to chew the young stems. These white stems are full of juice, and yeah, cattails would be a great option. Yeah, it's good.
And finally, I always have an umbrella with me to protect my camera while I'm filming, and it's very great to collect rain. Oh. The punk wood is an amazing material for the reason that it can almost be found everywhere on the planet. So no matter where you're stuck, you can find punk wood, and it's still a tinder that require a little bit of experience and a little bit of practice, because it will not produce a lot of flame. It will catch a spark, it will catch an ember, make it bigger and bigger, but from there it's good to mix it with another tinder that produce a lot of flame. But once you get used to this spongy wood, it will be part of your life, because I pretty much always use it to catch an ember. And as long as the wood is spongy and fluffy, it's very good. And very often inside trunk you can find this fluffy punk wood, and I think that it's some kind of animal that make their nest in this, and this stuff is just amazing. So very often, as I said, my tin bundle will be made of three layers. The third layer is something that keep my tin bundle in place. It produce some flame, but I don't really care if it's producing a lot of flame or not, as long as it doesn't kill my tin bundle. The second layer is something that produce a lot of flame, but it may not catch an ember so easily, like the birch bark. And the first layer is something that catch my tin bundle easily, but may not produce a lot of flame, but I don't care. It's only to catch the second and third layer on fire. And punk wood is just amazing for this. From these pieces, you can just crush them, make a fine fluffy powder. And you can also keep some bigger piece.
So as I said, not a big flame producer, but it catch an ember very, very, very easily. So you can take this characteristic, this positive characteristic, and mix it with a tinder that produce a lot of flame, but may not catch an ember so easily. Dead plant leaves are extremely efficient. There's different kind of leaves. Some are thicker than others. You want to look for these very thin ones. And in winter, these are always dry and really dead. And they are just amazing. So I just remove the leaves from the stems, and I end up with a thin bundle with only leaves, no stems, or almost no stems. You can remove the little ones like this. You make a bird nest and it's good to go for a spark or an ember too. This one burns real fast. The bark of the yellow birch tree is really amazing. It is highly flammable and is a really nice choice. Every trees will have different kind of bark. You can have trees that only have very thin bark like this, and this is amazing stuff, while other trees will have only a kind of bark like this, much thicker, and this is less good. It's still good. I will pick this one today to show you that it can still be used, but it needs to be processed a little bit. With the yellow birch or any birch, you want to crush the bark in your hands to make it very fluffy. Especially with the kind of bark that I got right now, some yellow birch got very thin, very nice bark that can pretty much take a spark even without rubbing it in your hand. But this one is thick and required to be processed. You want to make it fluffy and break all the big piece. Once again, make sure that your hands are dry. But this tinder usually take a little bit more strike. Huh, first time. It's stupid that I said that. Well, when you crush it in your hands, it takes very easily. Of course,
The white birch is a great, great tenders. As efficient as the yellow one. The dead needle of the pine tree is another great choice for tinder. This one can be a little bit more difficult to ignite though. It can be even difficult to ignite. But it produces a decent flame. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you what I like to eat in the forest when I spend overnight or when I spend a long time in the forest. But for that, we need a fire. To make my fire, I'm gonna make a bow draw fire in the rain. And to attach my bow, I'm gonna show you how to make a bowline knot, because it's a very effective way to attach it. So it's actually very easy to do. You just make a loop. Get into the loop under the rope and you come back in the loop and you got a bowline. So I would use this, and I will use this to attach my bow. Very effective. And you can also make the loop around a tree to leash an animal like my dog or whatever, a horse or whatever. Very effective. Or you can, and I think it's the most important application for this knot, you can strangle Handy if he doesn't accept your submission. So I think it's very, very good application for this too. Okay, so I'm ready. I got my kindling hidden under the wall. I got my set made of balsam fir, which is the species I trust the most in these conditions. I got my tin bundle in my pocket, and I'm not too worried about this one because I've collected before the rain start, and it's Nimbus stratus cloud, which is a light but long-term rain, and
in this condition, making a bow drill is not a lot more difficult. The only thing I like to do is bow for an additional 20 seconds or so when I see that I got an ember, because the ember tend to die because of the humidity in the air. It's the upside tip that made my spindle flip over. And I'm working in a swamp, which is not the best. Okay, I can see that I got an ember now, but I bow for an additional 15 or 20 seconds just to make sure it stays alive. I got a big ember. Okay, perfect. I put my spindle over the ember and I make sure everything is perfect. Before I catch my ember on fire, my tin bundle on fire, I make sure my hands are very dry before I touch my thin bundle, which is made of dead plant leaves and birch bark, which is of course very efficient in this condition. So my hands are dry. I make a bird nest with the dead plant's leaves first to catch my ember, and with the birch bark in second layer, which is gonna produce a lot of flame and keep everything in place pretty much. There we go. Oh, it's catching very well. I was expecting some more difficulties. You're set. You put it in the fire, and the next time you come back in the forest, you redo all the process again, because that's how you will learn. Sometimes it's very easy, but other times you will struggle for no reason, and that's friction fire. It's very complex. Today it was very easy. Other times it can take me like 2 hours. I'm gonna make a big fire because I need coals to make my food. I also like to put a lot of wood on top because all the time that it's gonna take to dry up, my fire under will be weaker, so it's a good timing. As it dry, it's gonna make the fire a good size, and because in this condition, as you can see, the fire struggle. And also, if I see that the fire is struggling too much, I will put some smaller wood on top and make a small pyramid. It's the pyramid fire, so the fire on top will drop coals on the wet, bigger woods, and it's gonna catch on fire slowly. So in other words, you make a fire on the fire. Oh, what a great feeling to make a fire in these conditions. Everything is soaking wet. Ah, and it's very cold too. So I will let this go and prepare the food so I can show you that.
I also like to use a little bit of green wood in my fire when I want to cook, like piece of wood of 1 inch or so, and they burn slowly and they make good coals too. Not too much of it. You just mix it with the dead wood. There we go. Now we got about 5 or 6 inches of coals and we are ready to cook. So right here is the food that I like to eat when I'm into the forest. First, we got spaghetti. Spaghetti is very nice at midday, because it gives a lot of energy for the rest of the day. It's easy to make and it's good without anything on it. You just eat it, you know, spaghetti alone. No need of, I don't know the word, sauce, sausage. Then, just before the night at 6, 7 or 8 o'clock, I always make good meat, often chicken, because it's just so good on the fire with the smokes and the coals. It gives an amazing taste to it. And always eat these with potatoes because they are easy to make and so good too, and it goes well together. Then, in midnight or in the morning, I always eat bannock. And bannock is really, really good. You got the recipe right here. So this is how you do it. Very simple, you do the mix. Then you twist it around a stick. And you turn it from time to time. It's gonna get swollen. And 30 minutes later, you got bread, fresh bread. And I like to eat this with maple syrup. It's just the best thing you will ever eat in your entire life. It's out of this world. And I always boil water on pot hooks. If my camera can make the focus, yeah. Very easy to make, no need of a saw. I always make it with my knife. And you're sure to not kill your amber. That still took a long time to make, you know. You don't want to ruin your fire because your water drops on it. And that's what I like to do. Great swamp.
The reason why I prefer spaghetti. Oh, there's a thunder. The reason why I prefer spaghetti over rice is because you simply need to make a little fork like this. You twist it in your spaghetti, and there you go. That's how I eat it all the time. It's very easy, and it's so good.
Oh, and I forgot to say, I always eat sunflowers, you know, during the day. As I walk, I eat this all day, and it contains a lot of protein, and it's good stuff. You're not hungry with this. You slowly eat it all day, and you will feel good. I attach it on my backpack like this, and I eat it all the time.